NFL on EA Sports, and this is Madden Ultimate Team. Straight ahead, we've got what should be an interesting matchup between the Los Angeles Rams and the Seattle Seahawks. With that, let's get up to Seattle. Standing by at CenturyLink Field, here are Brandon Gotten and Charles Davis.
Brandon Gotten, Charles Davis, happy to be with you. And Charles, we've got two teams who know each other extremely well. These division games, they tend to be battles.
People scout like crazy in this league, but no one scouts more than within the division. Because if you win your division, you're automatically in the playoffs. That puts extra emphasis on these games, and they can't wait to get at each other.
And the offense runs for a first down and 10.
Down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
They'll try to throw it here. Ben. The tight end Kittle has it on the left side. What a methodical drive this is turning out to be. That time 9 yards, and the sticks move again. And the pocket's been protected pretty good here so far on the opening drive.
We always talk about confidence in runners and catchers and quarterbacks. How about the protection detail? They're not allowing anyone near the guy throwing the football.
To throw, Vic. He's going to run for it deep left side. Got a man that's caught inside the 10. Touchdown, LA! Randy Moss. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Rams are an extra point away from tying up this football game.
That appeared like any routine NFL quarterback, but it was Michael Vick from the pocket, throws a touchdown pass. I just think about the transformation throughout his career. From Atlanta, where he would take off and go at just about the drop of a hat and turn defenses into mush. And then by the end of his career in Philadelphia, where he completed passes we just saw from the pocket, yet still have those great legs, when necessary, to help get him out of trouble.
A little surprising they wouldn't go for two, but this is up and good. And that will tie our game here in the third. Nothing separating these two teams as the kicks away here. This one taken for the seven. We'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. Hey, the first down carry. And he got blown up on that play. Back at the 20. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Every time I watch LT blow up plays just like that one, I think of one quote. You can run, but you can't hide.
He won a record 3 Defensive Player of the Year awards back in his day. He was also the league MVP in 1986.
One of 2 defensive players who won the MVP award in the NFL. The second one, Alan Page, with the Minnesota Vikings, the linchpin of their Purple People Eaters defense.
Back now in Seattle, Washington. All even as we get ready to start the fourth. On second down, here's Kelly. And hit behind the line. He lost the football. It's loose.
Wow. That ball is not free. But a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks them up.
And avoids the turnover. To throw is Wilson. He sets the fire deep. And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'd open up the defense a little bit. Loosen them up.
And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday.
They go into this type of a situation. Wiggins, and I think the ball's out, and the Rams have got it back.
Yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They'll run with a backup. This is Williams. And now Williams' yardage here. Knocks back to the 19-yard line. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. As they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game. Second and long, but you got to figure this almost certainly another run. On second down, Williams. And he's across for a touchdown. And the final minute, that should just about seal it.
And that touchdown should make you feel comfortable. But do you really feel like it's totally over yet?
Not totally, but I think you're pretty much there.
Yeah, you still got to make sure you stay with it, do all the right things down the stretch, especially on defense, but that touchdown there, you got to feel good about your chances.
Tucker now for the extra point. Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and the decision to just keep the extra point winds up successful. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Tyler Lockett now with the return. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Seahawks offense now, they get set to go back to work. All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. On first and 10, it's Wilson. He'll dump it off to both sides. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. It's a gain of 5. And it'll be second down. Short play like that in this situation, this late, that's a win for the defense.
No doubt. I remember something Coach Madden used to talk about all the time. Sometimes you can't just take what the defense gives you. You have to take what you need. And in this case, the offense is taking what the defense is giving them, not what they need.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Deion Sanders. And his guys will take over at their own 44-yard line.
Disappointing, but you had to go for broke here down two scores. So that force you to make some throws you definitely wouldn't want to make. And I think this interception is going to pretty much write an end to this one.
Get set to go now. puncher, the proverbial icing on the cake, if you will. Tucker now to add the point after. Tucker with the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. That is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Field it about a yard deep. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. Here come the Seahawks now, set to take over on offense. What do you do here down like this in this situation? Do you maybe just pick something out of the playbook you haven't called in a while, or you call it a day?
You can do that, or you pick something that's a staple for you and should work better and try and execute that on the way out the door, and maybe get back to base and feel a little bit better as you end the ball game. It's been a frustrating one for you.
We'll see if they go back to base.
Encroachment, defense.
A little antsy on the left side of the line.
Yeah, I think they got the guy in the end. I think they got the DN there on that one. And let's face it, he is so amped up, wanting to get a good get off on the snap, jump too quickly.
So a first and five now after the 5-yard penalty from the neutral zone infraction. Now they'll throw it with Wilson. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete. He was looking for his big target, Brandon Marshall. And that'll bring up second down.
And that's what he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
On second down, Wilson. And down he goes on the pressure from the Rams defense. Khalil Mack able to get in there and drop him for a 2-yard loss. Trick play doesn't work. Good reaction there defensively. And it'll be fourth down. And Sanders now returning. Shifts past him at the 45. But Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. What were they clicking on offense?
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points. Continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.